God is so good. Amen. God is wonderful. Amen. Good to see you all this afternoon. You are all looking smashing and wonderful in the presence of God. We thank God for that. And we appreciate Him that we have woken up this morning and that we have come to worship Him. It's not easy. As the pastor was saying, I was listening to that earthquake on radio, and I was, my heart went out to the families. And above all, I was watching the child in need. There are things that captured me when they were telling a story of a young girl who was suffering with cancer, and how brilliant she was, and how this child in need are helping all these people, and they bringing the place where there was fire as well. The man was helping the youths there, and how he was crying. It captured my heart and said, wow, God, give us a baby. Because it's out of these pressures that the babies are born. And it's out of this when God shows you and leads you to see, He gives you a baby. Like what the pastor was saying this afternoon, the book of Nehemiah, it was a baby. The man just looked at his brother, asking the question, see, the survivors are in trouble. He was moved by the Spirit of God. Indeed, we have to be receptive and be open, even in a time like this, to hear what God is saying to us as we move on and as we minister the gospel. Amen.
Amen.
So let's thank God for today. Father, we thank you.
Hallelujah.
We give you glory. We know you are with us. You know you have begun with us. Our Father, Lord, we pray that let your name be glorified. We pray that, Lord, may you be exalted. Father, we pray that you forgive our sins and cleanse us from all our unrighteousness. You told us in your word that if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess, you are faithful to forgive us and cleanse us. Wash us this afternoon as we hear your word. Cause us to act to your way and be the doers of the way. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Wonderful. I'm still the old fashioned, the person who likes writing. My same ones, my pastor all the time, but for me, I like it. I take pleasure in writing. I'm so slow on the computer. So I like writing. So I'm still doing the same. Amen. So I'm going to share with you the subject that I'm calling When Forgiveness Is Not Easy. When forgiveness is not easy. Brothers and sisters, sometimes we go through issues in life when we find it very difficult to forgive. But we are going to look into the scripture and see how God can help us in terms of releasing ourselves and forgiving those who have offended us. Sometimes we think that Christianity has set an impossible standard when it calls on every believer to forgive. We think that Christianity has set a very high standard and we seem to be very impossible to forgive. But the Bible says, all things are possible.
Amen.
Amen. All things are possible. Whatever it may be, all things are possible. To him who believes, all things are possible. There are three reasons that makes us that makes very difficult to forgive. There are three reasons that makes people feel very difficult to forgive. Number one, we do not have sufficiency. When we look into ourselves, we are not sufficient enough to forgive. We, on our own, we are not sufficient enough. When we realize that we are not sufficient to forgive, we need to think that Christ has forgiven us. When you look into yourself and say you cannot forgive, but look at what Christ has forgiven you from. What Christ forgave you. When you find it difficult to forgive others, look at what Christ did for you. The Bible says he gave up all the glory to come down to forgive you and me. Have you ever met some people who said, over my dead body? But God has made it possible that we should forgive and release him. We do not have the sufficient in ourselves when we deeply realize how much we ourselves have been forgiven. We need to deeply realize how much we ourselves have been forgiven. Me, myself, how often people are forgiven. And above all, Christ has forgiven me. So it makes me and you feel at a position where we can say, I can forgive. Because even me, myself, I do wrong others. When forgiveness is not easy. Sometimes the second thing is that we hold resentment towards the person who has hurt us. We hold that resentment. And you know what it does when you do that? It just hits you up. The person you are hating is already gone. But you who is holding on to, you are hating within yourself. And you cannot move on. One thing that we should bear in mind when we feel like that, we should realize what the book of Romans chapter 12 verse 19 says. It is man to avenge. Amen. Romans chapter 12 verse 19, the Bible says, it is mine to avenge. I will repay, says the Lord. Amen. So if someone has really hit you and has done something that is not good, you need to bear in mind. Don't have to hold on to resentment. Realize that being hurt, having the sense of control, you cannot move. Know that Christ says that it is mine to avenge. I will repay, says the Lord. Forgiveness involves giving up control and trusting God with the outcome. Amen. Amen. Giving up the control and trust God for the outcome. We need to come to a place where we say, like what Jesus said, the Lord, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing.
Amen.
And we need the grace to come to that place. Mm-hmm. And we need the love of God and the compassion, as the pastor was saying this afternoon, the compassion of Jesus can compel you to give up, can compel you to say, I give up control and I trust you, Lord, for the outcome. We need to do that. And the other thing that causes us to feel it is that we trust so much. We may find it difficult to forgive. It's because we might misplace dependency. We have misplaced friendship. You know, there are some people, they can cling to you. They can cling to you. And you can cling to them to say, I cannot live without you. We always say that. I cannot live without him. And that's a misplaced dependency. Mm-hmm. Our dependency is on God. Mm-hmm. People of this world will pass away. Mm-hmm. But if we put our trust in God, we'll stand firm. If our dependence is on God, whatever happens within us, we'll look to God. Because that means in him we trust. Because our dependence is on Jesus Christ. Not on another thing. And even the things we have, they are for temporal. Mm-hmm. One day they'll go away. One day we may not have them. So we need to make sure that we put our dependence on God. We occupy ourselves in believing that God is our sufficient. God is our everything. We need to put our trust in God. When we are hit, we need to realize that our souls are being destroyed. We are feeling being disturbed. We are feeling being hurt. But God is bigger than all that. We need to develop a very close relationship with God so that we are safe in Him. And the other thing that we need to realize is that people cannot destroy us. No. Even when people are hurt, they never destroy you. No ways. People can say things about you that will never destroy you. Only God can do that. Matthew chapter 10, verse 28, the Bible says, it is not easy. It is a lot easier to forgive when we see that our life is not in people, but in God. It is a lot easy to forgive when we see that our life is not in people, but in God. That will help us to forgive when we realize that our lives are in God, not in people. The one thing that I want all of us to remember for today, and the thing that should stick in us, is this. Forgiveness is very important in life. We must remember, it's not so much a feeling, but a decision. It is not so much a feeling. Forgiveness is not a feeling that, oh, today I feel like forgiving. No. It's a decision that we make to say, I am going to forgive. It's an action, an act of will. You have to decide. You make a decision, an act of a will. You decide to forgive, whether you feel it or not. You supply the willingness. If you supply the willingness, God will supply the power.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If you are willing, God will give you what you need. The Bible says, if you are willing, you walk in this power. If you are willing, you shall eat the fruit of the land.
Amen.
If you are willing, if the willingness is there, God will supply the power. God will supply the grace. Amen. Now let's look into the Word of God, and let's have 8 things to consider as we live, as we continue forgiving one another. Number one, consider the extent of the divine forgiveness. Consider the extent of the divine forgiveness. How God has forgiven you divinely. Psalms 103, verse 12. As far as the east is from the west. Amen. That's how extended God has forgiven you. Consider the extent of divine forgiveness. Just as these two hands cannot meet when you do like this. That's how far God has forgiven us. God has, as far as the east is from the west, so far He has removed our transgression from us. Amen.
Amen.
So consider that when you are not feeling like forgiving, when it's not easy to forgive, consider that as far as the east is from the west, that's how far the Lord has removed our transgression from you and from me. He has forgiven us. And number two, God is the only avenger. Amen. God is the only avenger of evil. As I said in Romans chapter 12, verse 19, do not take vengeance, my friends, but leave room for God's wrath. For it is written, it is mine to avenge. I will repay, says the Lord.
Amen.
I think in August, we went to London with my family. We met this lovely lady. She's been suffering a lot. So I tried to sit down with her, and said, what is going on? Oh no, I'm depressed. I'm this. I said, no. I asked the question to say, have there been any, are you holding on to something, or are people in your life, have they had done something to you? Or is there anyone in your life who has hurt you? The woman said, no. I said, no. There's just something. It's not adding up. Something is wrong somewhere here. I said, but why? I said, no. Are you holding on to anyone, or are you developing inner bitterness? Because what unforgiveness does, it can make you crippled. It can make you sick. So, talking to this woman, so she refused. I told my wife, oh, something is not straight here. I don't have the peace of mind. Something is going on, which I can't put my finger on. But we keep on praying. So we went back, we came back, we continued praying for this lady. So one day, I phoned her and said, look, can we talk? Because then she opened up to me, yeah, you know, I've been looking after the kids of my late sister. They just turned against me, they took me to court. I said, now you're talking. So as this affected her, I said, that did affect my life. Very bad. And then I said, are you finding it difficult to release them, to forgive them? I said, I don't want them to go there. It's so hard for me. They have hurt me. After I've done what I've done to them, and this is what they have done to me. I said, well, look, vengeance belongs to the Lord. Mm-hmm. What we are encouraged is to release people. I know it is hard. I know I cannot understand. I know you don't need to tell me the detail of it all. But what I can assure you is that if you release them, you find that your life will be at peace. Mm-hmm. So she was saying, I can't sleep. I go to bed 2 a.m. I said, what do you do? No, I just can't. I said, no, there's something. So we continued talking. And then she told me another story. So, oh, there's this person. He was at workplace, at workmate. She turned her family against me. I said, look, it's high time we moved on by releasing them. Mm. So as we were talking, she happened to meet the same woman. And in the moment she saw her, something left on her. She felt, I said, hi, I've missed you, I haven't seen you for ages. And then something behind her said, now can you tell her of what she did to you? I said, no. I told her, look, the best thing to do is just to keep quiet and read the Bible, begin a new chapter.
Amen.
I said, exactly what you have said, that's what I decided to do. And today, I can sleep. Mm-hmm. Today, I can go to bed. I can say, I'm sleeping tonight. And indeed, I sleep. Mm-hmm. I said, you see how bondage you've been, under bondage all these years, and the people you've been feeding for, they have moved on. Mm-hmm. And they are doing fine. And you are on tablets of depression, you are on physio, you are building yourself, you are over things that can be released to the Lord. Mm-hmm. And today, when you speak to this lady, she's so cheerful.
Amen.
And happy. I said, look, this is what God can do. Mm-hmm. When you supply the willingness, God will supply the power. Amen. When you are willing to say, I'm giving it up, I'm trusting God for the outcome, a life becomes easy. And look how many years you have wasted. And on these years, you have even been on sick, they have been diagnosed with depression, mental, over the things that you would have let go. And you would have lived a very happy life. It's not too late. You can live that even now. So the Bible says, brothers and sisters, it is mine to avenge.
Amen.
Vengeance belongs to me.
Amen.
The Lord will avenge, whatever it may be. Whatever. Have you ever been living, but behind you somebody is harder than yours? And you don't know. And when you come to discover, it hurts. One of the things that the Bible is very clear, David, I think in the book of Psalms 53, David ran away from Saul, and he went to another city. And when he went to that city, he saw a man he knew in that place. He appeared to be insane. He appeared to be insane in that king. And when the king looked at David, he said, why have you brought this man in my presence? He's so insane. Can you take him out of here?